Hello, welcome back to the Google IT course. Today we're going to discuss about networking services connecting to internet, session 2. In the last session we've learned about how to enable the routing, the different types of routing protocols, and we have actually configured the router so that it can allow the data to go from one network to the remote network. So today we're going to continue those discussions and actually see what are the requirements to connect to internet, what are the components required for accessing internet, also to discuss about the differences between the private IP address and public IP address, and what are the range of private IP addresses and public IP addresses. And we'll also discuss about an important concept called network address translation, because to be able to access internet, the network address translation is mandatory. So let's get into the session by looking at what we have, the contents to learn. And in this page, we see that the different types of IP addresses, that is public IP address and private IP address. So the IPv4 addresses are divided into two categories called public IP address and private IP address. These public IP addresses are those which are provided by the internet service provider, ISP. Public IPs are always allocated by the ISP. Whereas the private IP addresses are those which are allocated by the local administrator, and these IP addresses are free to be used. But which is the scope of the private IP addresses and which is the scope of public IP addresses? In the earlier session, we have learned about the total range of IP addresses for each class. And we also learned about the class A, the class B and class C type of addresses and their ranges. So from each of this class, certain IP addresses have been reserved and they have been assigned as private IP addresses. And we can see in this page the total set of public private IP addresses reserved, and these are the private IP addresses reserved in class A. Only the 10.0.0.0 network is reserved, which means there are about 16 million IP addresses. There are about 16 million private IP addresses in this class A reserved networks. Whereas in class B, there are about 16 different class B networks reserved, and each of this class B network provides 65,534 IP addresses. And in class C, we have 256 class C networks, and each class C networks provides up to 254 IP addresses. It's going to be 254 multiplied by 256 to get the total range of private IP addresses. So these are the addresses that are free to use, and any organization can make use of these IP addresses. And the important rule is that the public IP addresses are those which are other than what is mentioned here in this class A, B and C. They are called as public IP addresses. And private IP addresses we cannot use to access internet. Means when your computer has a private IP addresses, we cannot access internet. So that is the important rule in the IPv4 addresses. If you want to access internet, we must have public IP address. Private IP addresses are free and they are listed here. These are the private IP addresses. Any organization can make use of these private IP addresses. So what are the requirements to access internet or to provide internet? So the following are the requirements to access internet. The first one is we must have an internet connection from the internet service provider in the form of a cable or maybe in the form of a wireless communication. So once we have the physical connection coming from the ISP to our home, to our office, the second requirement is the ISP must provide public IP addresses. So if you look at this example of consider this is the ISP, Internet Service Provider, and he is providing this cable to our home or office, and we are connecting this to mostly a Wi-Fi router. So, a wireless router will be available. This is wireless router. And this is the cable that is provided by the ISP. And we connect this cable exactly on the WAN port of the router. There will be a WAN port on the router, and this is connected. This ISP's cable is connected to this. And then we may have at the home, we may have the laptops or tabs or smartphones. We use various devices. All these are wireless. These are all wireless devices. Through Wi-Fi, we want to access internet at home. So, this is our home or a small office. This is home or office, and these are the various devices like laptop, PC, or smartphone. So, these are the devices that we want to connect to internet. So, we have seen the components. One is the internet connection, the cable coming from the ISP, and then once connected to the internet, ISP would provide public IP address, and he would provide the public IP address to this particular wireless router on the WAN port. We have seen the router being there. And the fourth one is the users or the devices, network devices, which are used by the users will be given a private IP address. So, which means these devices will be having the private IP addresses. This will be having the private IP addresses, and the ISP would provide the public IP address here. So, all these private users will now have to access internet, but it is contradicting our statement that to have internet access, we must have public IP address only. But if you look at the total scope of IPv4 addresses, IPv4 addresses approximately 4 billion addresses available. But out of these, there are some reserved IP addresses which cannot be used. But today, the number of devices across the globe which are accessing internet is far more than what is actually available. So, there was a process that was designed called network address translation. With the help of network address translation, we can convert the private IP address to the public IP address and then access the internet for all the internal users. So, let us look at what we have here. These are the requirements. We have an internet connection, the ISP would allocate the public IP address, and we have a router in our home or office, and then the internal users have private IP addresses. So, the next important aspect to know about the public IP addresses, importance of public IP addresses to access internet. Since we are already aware about the range of private IP addresses, other than these private IP addresses, they are all public IP addresses, and they are allocated by this global body called IANA. How are the IP addresses allocated? Internet Assigned Numbers Authority. This is the global body which manages both IP version 4 and IP version 6 IP addresses. This organization will allocate the IP addresses to whom? To Regional Internet Registry. RIR stands for Regional Internet Registry. There are 5 such global bodies. There are 5 such global internet registries depending upon the region. So, India falls under the category called Asia Pacific Internet Network Information Center, APNIC. We call this as APNIC. APNIC is the region where India falls under. So, under this RIR are the ISPs across these regions. So, if you consider BSNL as one ISP, or Airtel or Tata or Reliance, whoever it is, these ISPs have to ask the RIR for the public IP addresses, and this RIR in turn will get IP addresses from the global body called AINA, Internet Assigned Numbers Authority, and these ISPs in turn will allocate the IP address to the end users like us or organizations, companies. So they have, where do we get these IP addresses from? From ISP. Where do ISP get the IP address from? Regional Internet Registry. And where do these RIRs get IP from? From the global body called IANA, Internet Assigned Numbers Authority. So that's the concept. And we have to know that only the public IP addresses which are assigned by the ISP are routable or usable on internet. We will not be able to access internet from the private IP address. Even if some user try to access internet with a private IP address, he will not be able to get connected. He will not be able to access the websites because the request will not be processed by the ISPs. So only one IP address will be provided by the ISP to the users, small users, home users, broadband users. Only one public IP address will be assigned to the users. But in the network, in the organization, in the home, there will be multiple users who wants to access internet at the same time. So to provide internet to all the users at the same time, we have to use the concept called network address translation, or NAT. So NAT is very important, and we must enable this on our router so that users can access internet. So let's discuss about what is NAT, network address translation. It is the process of converting one IP address into another. Translation is converting one IP into another. So here network address actually refers to IP address. Network address means IP address. And translation is converting from one IP to another IP address. So normally there are different types of translation available. There are different methods of translation available. But most times or widely used method is to convert the private IP addresses which are used in the local area network of the various organizations and homes to public IP address. And why should this happen? Because to able to access internet, we must have public IP address only. So the LAN private IP addresses will be converted to public IP addresses assigned by the ISP. And when your request goes out of your network to the internet, when the reply come back, it will come back as public IP address. It will again be converted into local IP address or private IP address. So the process of converting a private IP address into public IP address and public IP address into private IP address is called as NAT, or network address translation. And there are different types of methods of translation available. We're going to discuss about the most widely used among all these called port address translation. This is the method that we are going to use on our routers and going to configure and verify the output. Port address translation. So static NAT is another method used, and this is required or to be used only when an organization has public servers. When the organization has public servers. So what do we mean by public servers? Let's suppose an organization has a website hosted in their network. Let's say we have in our office a web server. Let's say apssidc.gov.in. Or maybe yahoo.com or google.com, some website that we are hosting in our network. And users from internet, all over internet, want to access this server which is in our office. So we have to enable the static NAT in our network for allowing the users from internet to access the server in our office. We have to implement static NAT. So hence we say, if an organization has public servers, then we must enable the static NAT. But if you want our local users to access internet, then we must enable this port address translation. Both these are important, but static NAT used only when you have a server in your network. But to access internet, which is common for everybody today to use internet, so PAT is a feature that is available to be configured on the routers. But in the small home office routers which we use, this feature is enabled by default. So normally what we do, we buy this router and then just connect the cable coming from the ISP and then we start using it. We call this as plug and play because all the required configurations are already set into this device. But now today we're going to look at how we actually enable this configuration and then test the communication. So if you look at this topology we have today, this is different from yesterday's topology. Yesterday we have used only two routers, but today we have three routers and slightly the configuration has been changed. But the local IP address of the PCs remain the same. You can see here, this is the IP address of this computer, the same thing that we used yesterday. IP config will provide the local computer's details. And then this computer here also has a private IP address which is from a different series, IP config. So yesterday we have made static routing so that these two PCs can communicate with each other. But what's different in today's topology is that this is one organization which is available in Amravati, and this is another organization which is available in Hyderabad, and both these organizations are connected to the ISP. Both these organizations are connected to the ISP. So when you connect to the ISP, as discussed, we will be provided with the public IP addresses. So I'm going to show you some output of the router's configuration, which is slightly different from yesterday's. So the commands that we have learned yesterday, we will use enable to come to the privilege mode. And to verify the configuration, the command is show space running hyphen config. This is the command which will enable us to check the current status of the router's configuration. So this is some part of the output display. There is still some additional information. So you get this more. More represents there is more information available. So you can either press the enter key to check one line at a time, or you can press the space bar on the keyboard and you can get one full screen at a time. So this is the IP that we allocated to the fast Ethernet interface yesterday. And for serial interface, we had a different IP address used, that was 172.16.0.1. So but today you see there is a different IP address because we've changed this to the public IP address. This is the public IP address allocated by the internet service provider. So we have changed the WAN interface IP address to public because allocated by the ISP. In a similar way, on the Hyderabad router also, we have changed the WAN interface IP address. The LAN interface IP address remain the same, and the command to verify is show space running hyphen config. This command would display the current status of the interfaces of the router. So we can see here the Ethernet interface IP address as well as the serial interface IP address. So this is the public IP address and this is the private IP address, because in the LAN we have a lot of computers and servers. Okay. So now with this, we want to communicate from the Amravati computer to the router, public IP address of the router. So this is the IP address we want to go to communicate from this PC. So we go to this PC and ping with the IP address, ping space 202.2.0.18. So we want to communicate with the router. So you get a message called destination host unreachable. Destination host unreachable. This is an error message. And we get this message from the device IP, which is our router. This is the IP address of the router. So remember, this is the IP address which is replying to us that there is no route or path to the destination. Destination host unreachable. This is being displayed from the router, which means our router do not have the path, the local router, do not have the path to send the message to Hyderabad or from Hyderabad to Amaravati. So to be able to perform that, we have to enable something called as routing. We have to enable the routing. So port address translation is a method which converts many private IP addresses which are in the local network into one public IP address. Translation from many private IP addresses into one single public IP address. And this public IP address are provided by the ISP. He will give only one public IP address, and in our network we have multiple users, and all these private IPs are converted into one single public IP address. So with PAT enabled on the router, all users can access the internet at the same time. So on the home broadband routers or the Wi-Fi routers, this PAT feature is enabled by default. We don't have to do any additional configuration. So just PAT does not suffice. We need to enable a default route. Remember when we discussed about the types of routing in the previous session, we have discussed about static route, dynamic route, and default route. So we have to enable the default route on the router. So the command that is required to enable the default route is mentioned here. In the configuration mode, we have to give this command IP space route followed by 0.0.0.0, where this represents any destination. You want to access any destination, it represents 0.0.0.0. Any destination. And this next zeros represent any subnet mask, and then the next exit interface. So we are now going to enable that specific default route on these Amaravati router as well as Hyderabad router. Whenever you connect to internet, you must enable the default route towards ISP on all the routers connecting towards internet service provider. So we log into this router, go to the configuration mode, configure terminal, and then give the command IP space route 0.0.0.0. On all the four octets, the value will be 0, means any destination, because on internet we have millions of destinations. On the internet, you want to access, there are hundreds of thousands of destinations. We cannot keep a route available for each and every destination or for each and every website. So whenever a router is connected to internet, we must enable the default route, and the default route goes as IP route 0.0.0.0, means any destination, followed by 0.0.0, which is any subnet mask. And then we have to specify the exit interface, through which interface the router is connected to the ISP. So we have 0.0.0.0 followed by the exit interface, which is serial 0/0/0. So with this static default route created on the router, we need to verify the routing table whether this particular route got established in the routing table of the router. This has to be established in the routing table, and verification of the routing table with the command show IP route. So you can see here in this output, there is one special entry called S star. S star represents static default route, which means now if any route is not available in the routing table, the router will forward the packet to this particular destination via this particular path. But if you check currently in Hyderabad router, we do not have that entry on the Hyderabad router. If we check the output of show IP route command, you won't have that default route because we have not yet enabled. We have not yet enabled the default route on that route. There is no static route, default route here. So the command to enable the default route is IP route 0.0.0.0, which is any destination, and 0.0.0.0, any subnet mask, via serial 0/0/0. Whatever is the interface, it may be different in your case. So now we have the option available. So we have the default route available on both Hyderabad router as well as Amravati router. And now if you try to ping from the local PC here, if you try to ping to the remote public IP address, ping 202.2.0.18, you won't get response still. But you won't get the message destination host unreachable. You'll get request timed out. So the message is different. Now, after creating the default route on the Amravati router as well as Hyderabad router, the local PC is sending the packet to the router and the router has a default route available towards ISP. But local PC has private IP address. But from private IP address, we cannot access the public IP address. So we need to enable this concept called PAT. Port address translation has to be configured on both Amravati router as well as Hyderabad router. Then we will be able to communicate from the local private network to the public network. So let's look at the configuration commands to enable the PAT, port address translation. So we have to now get into the router, Amravati router first, and then configure terminal interface, the ones which we have used, fast Ethernet 0/0, IP NAT inside, representing that this is a local LAN interface. Then interface serial 0/0/0, which is a WAN interface, IP NAT outside, representing that this is the interface connecting towards the ISP. And then we have to create an access list. Access list, you can give any number between 1 to 99, and then permit space the local network 192.168.201.0, and then there's a wildcard mask 0.0.0.255, and then give the command IP NAT inside source list. We have created an access list with number 12, so that number has to be substituted here, access list 12, then interface, the interface which is provided by the ISP, which is connecting to the interface, access list number 12, then interface serial 0/0/0, this is the interface which is connecting towards ISP, and then the keyword called overload. So with this, the PAT configuration on Amravati router is complete. But if you verify the output of the command show IP route, you still have the default route which is required for internet access. And now I'm going to establish communication from the local PC here in Amravati, because the Amravati router's PAT configuration is complete. So now we have to check the communication. So I'm going to ping to the same public IP address, and then I just use the up arrow key from the command prompt, and now you can see there is communication. So which means this computer, this particular computer is saying that I want to reach the public IP address of the Hyderabad network, and the request is coming all the way from the PC to the switch. Switch is forwarding to the router. On the router, this particular private IP address has been replaced with the public IP address assigned by the ISP. So this process of converting private IP address to public IP address is called as PAT, port address translation. So now if we go back to the router to verify the output of the command show IP NAT translation, this is the command to verify the output. So you can see there's a long output here. So let's see how we read this. So in this output, we have protocol, means what type of protocol is used for communication. Ping and traceroute commands use ICMP protocol. ICMP protocol, Internet Control Message Protocol. If you use any web traffic or FTP traffic, then it will use TCP protocol. Then we have inside global, The inside global represents the public IP address assigned by the ISP to the customer, to the user. Then this port number, this is the port number. We have mentioned earlier, for website it is port number 80, for FTP it is port number 21, for DNS it is port number 53. So these are the port numbers reserved for the services or network services or applications. The next column is the inside local, which represents the private IP address of the local computer generating the request. Then outside local and outside global, both these represent the remote destination. This is the remote computer or router IP address which we are trying to send data. Okay, so this is how we are able to access the internet with a private IP address. The router is converting your local private IP address into public IP address with the help of network address translation method called PAT. Because NAT has different types like static NAT, dynamic NAT, PAT, port redirection NAT. So multiple types of NAT is available. So the method that we have enabled on the local router is PAT, port address translation. But we now go back to the Hyderabad router PC and then try to ping to this public IP address of Amaravati network. So the command is ping followed by the public IP address 192.1.0.17. This is the public IP address of Amaravati route. So you get a message, request timed out. Because the default route is available, you get a message called request timed out. You're not able to get the output. So now we have to enable the port address translation on the Hyderabad router. So the commands to configure on the Hyderabad router, configure terminal, then interface, fast ethernet, 0/0, because this is a LAN interface, the command is ipnat inside and interface serial 0/0/0, the interface connecting towards the ISP, then the command IP NAT outside and then create an access list number can be any number between 1 to 99, and then permit the local network of Hyderabad, which is 192.168.202.0 and 0.0.0.255, is basically the wildcard mask, which is opposite of subnet mask or inverse of subnet mask. And then IP NAT inside source list followed by the access list number we have used here. So the same number has to be defined, and then interface serial port number is 0/0/0 and then overload. With this command we will be able to allow internet access. So now we come back to this computer from where we did not get the output to access the Hyderabad to Amaravati public IP address. So you see, now you get a response. So this is how the PAT helps the local users of an organization or a home which have a lot of private IP addresses to access internet. So you can confirm from the router with the command show IP NAT translation. So you can see here the local IP address of the PC is 192.168.202.10. And he is able to translate, the router is able to translate his public IP address to the private IP address to the public IP address and then reach the remote network. Okay. So just as an example, let me take you to my computer, my local PC. I am not using the simulator now. This is my laptop. And I check IP config, which is providing me the current IP addresses on my computer, and I am using the keyword more means it will show one screen at a time. So on my Wi-Fi interface, on my Wi-Fi interface, you can see there is a private IP address. See the IP address that's mentioned here, 192.168.43.35. And then the default gateway is 192.168.43.1. So this is the parameters that I have on my computer. But this is a private IP address. This is a private IP address. So with this private IP address, I should not get internet. But you observe here, I said ping zoomgroup.com and I get the response. So what's happening here? My request is forwarded from my computer, which has a private IP address, to the default gateway, which is the router. And the router is converting this private IP address into the corresponding public IP address. So just to show you, if you have to find out, you are having access to internet in your home. Now we want to check what IP address was allocated to your computer. So there is a website called www.whatismyip.com. This is a website which provides the actual public IP address allocated to you, your organization, to your router from the ISP. So you can see here the first line, your public IP address is mentioned here, 27.59.199.226. And this whatismyip.com is a website which is providing this service, and you can see what public IP address was assigned to you by your ISP. In fact, it will also display information about your local IP address. You see, my computer IP address also has been displayed, 192.168.43.35. We have seen here in the previous page, this was the IP address allocated to the computer, to the laptop by the local router. And this is the public IP address assigned by the ISP towards the router. And it also mentioned who the ISP is. The name of the ISP also will be displayed in this screen. So it is a very useful website, whatismyip.com. There's no space, it's one word, whatismyip.com. And you can see the public IP address allocated to your router and your computer's IP address and the name of the ISP, the location, all these details. Okay. So finally, what we have learned today in the session is about the difference between the private IP address and the public IP address, the importance of public IP address. To access internet, we must have public IP address. But within the LAN, within the organization, to communicate from one computer to another computer or from the computer to the server, we just require private IP addresses. But who allocates these public IP addresses? ISPs. ISPs give public IP address to the end users and customers. And these ISPs get public IP address from the regional internet registry, and these get from the global body called AINA, Internet Assigned Numbers Authority. But just having a public IP address alone is not enough for the whole network, because one single IP is allocated to the router, but within the network we have multiple computers. They all have private IP addresses. So with a private IP, we cannot access internet. So on the router, we have to enable a feature called PAT, Port Address Translation. And with the help of the port address translation, we are able to translate or convert the private IP address into public IP address and then access the internet. So in this session and in the previous session, we learned about the various concepts relating to internet access, internet connection, what are the prerequisites, what features have to be enabled, including the default route. By just configuring the PAT and not having the default route, we will not be able to access internet. So we have a router. ISP gives a public IP address to the router, and we have to enable the default route, then we have to enable the PAT. So with this, we will be able to access internet. And in all the small home broadband routers, these features are enabled by default. Only when you buy professional routers, which are used for large organizations, we must enable these configurations. Okay, I hope this session was useful to you and it will help you in getting greater knowledge in configuring the routers for accessing internet. Thank you.